It is a very good morning and welcome to the Emirates Arena here in Glasgow for finals day in the Scottish Open Grand Prix. We're after 4 days of endeavour, sublime badminton, as well as hard work. The players who have made it through to the business end of the tournament can almost reach out and grab a title. But there's a world of play today and five finals for us to get our teeth in today. Starting off with the women's singles final, Sayaka SATO of Japan, the unseeded player against Beatriz CORRALES of Spain, the number two seed. Followed by, once again, the women's doubles, Gabriela Stoeva with her sister, Gabriela, the number one seed from Bulgaria against the unseeded English duo, Heather Oliver and Lauren Smith.
Please welcome the court officials for the women's singles final, led on by umpire Marcel Schoolmans from the Netherlands and service judge Sarah Halley from Scotland.
Well, we started off on Wednesday here in Glasgow, and here we are, the final day on Sunday, where all of the titles will be handed out to the winners of their respective discipline here. It is a wonderful setting, a wonderful scene here in Glasgow, and the supporters here, we hope, are going to enjoy some fantastic badminton, as we have done throughout the start of the tournament. Almost definitely a case of a ladies first here this afternoon in Glasgow. It's good to see Beatriz CORRALES of Spain once again participate here at Glasgow. And it is this lady designated with the task here, indeed, to perhaps get herself a title and what would be a fantastic achievement for someone who hasn't been around in the badminton world for much time indeed. Sayaka SATO of Japan looking to emulate former Japanese winners here, 2012. Takahashi won the title here, as well as Yonkura in 2007 and Shimada in 2002. Well, a very good morning to your badminton enthusiasts. My name is Earl Creary, inside the commentary booth, and I have the honour and pleasure to be alongside Gail Ems, MBE, and former Silver Olympic medal winner in the Athens 2004 Olympics. Welcome, Gail. What a day of badminton we should have in store for us today.
I am so looking forward to this. It was incredible yesterday, and I think the finals are just going to be the icing on the cake. It was world-class stuff, and I'm just really looking forward to seeing another quality today of badminton.
Well, this time last year, we did have a Spanish winner in the women's singles. Warren won the title last year, not back this year to defend that title. And it is her very good friend, Beatriz CORRALES, who made it through all the way from Thursday, in fact. She's the one-seeded player of the two here this morning in Glasgow.
SATO of Japan has the number two seed, Beatriz CORRALES of Spain.
We have a Dutch umpire for the first final of the day. Marcel Schoolmans is in the hot seat. Let's hope it is a wonderful game of badminton to start off proceedings for the day here in Glasgow. It really was yesterday. The semi-finals, Gail, at times had us all on the edge of our seats.
It was incredible, and what I love about the later stages of tournaments is you never know what you're going to expect, but you know that there's going to be a fighting spirit on court. These players really want to win the Scottish Open, and we saw that in abundance yesterday. We saw so much fighting spirit. We saw the physicality of badminton. There were no easy matches whatsoever. We saw different styles of badminton. We saw the fast pace of the men's doubles, and then the slower style of the late singles and men's singles. So it was a treat for everyone. There was something for everyone.
Absolutely, it was a spectacle to say the least. Where are the stats here for the 23-year-old from Sendai, Japan, currently world ranked 43. Way of her career high, in fact, to 14 in August 2012. She's just getting a feel for things again on the court, Gail, recovering from that injury she had.
It's taken her 2 years. That's an incredibly long time in the world of sport that she's been out injured. But she's got no strapping on her ankles. It was a heavy fall. I remember it. I remember it well. I saw it. I saw her being stretched off the court, and she was in floods of tears, which you can, you know, can't fault her for that. She was so distraught, especially in the Olympic Games as well. But she's in such great shape. We can see that from here just by looking at her body. But, you know, just incredible mental strength as well.
Here's her opponent for the day, Sato. It is the number two seed from Spain, world rank 29, a right-handed player, was as high as 24 just last month, in fact. Spain's number two behind her good friend Marin, and the winner here this time last year in the women's singles, who comes into the Scottish Open Grand Prix in fantastic form, I must say. 39 victories year to date and 24 defeats, 140-73 with regards to her form in her career, with already two titles so far in 2014. There's Sato's road to the final. So far, only once has she dropped a game, Gail, and that being yesterday against Kirsty Gilmour of Scotland, the number one seed.
And Kirsty Gilmour had a chance in that match. She could have and should have possibly won that match. So she's, I won't say lucky to be in the final. You're never lucky to be in the final. You earn your place in the final. But, you know, she had a bit of a scare. So she, hopefully she's recovered and ready for the final.
Well, as it is for Corrales, as it was for Sato as well, just the one game dropped, and that being in round two against Fabienne Depres of Germany. So she's also in good shape. Smooth sailing against the Indian yesterday in the semi-final. Two games to
left. Beatriz Corrales.
What will happen here for either player in the final? It is eyes down, ready to go. We're about to get up and underway. It is finals day here in the 2014 Scottish Open Grand Prix, starting off with the women's singles final. And it is, without further ado, the number two seed for the first serve.
One love. Two love.
These are the most nervous times when you're in a final. The walkout's bad enough, the crowd, the lights are down. Just testing each other out.
Three, love.
Well, she may be the number two seed out there today, Corrales, but it is Sato who leads the head-to-head stakes. One match to zero, in fact, and that was all the way back in 2011. Now, Corrales is just 21, Sato 23. ...21-8, 21-12 that day at the Unix US Open Grand Prix Finals.
That was a good long rally. That will settle the nerves. The adrenaline is pumping. Why so often you see really short rallies at the start of matches because everyone's so tense, but that one will have calmed both the girls down.
Serve's over. 4-1.
Start here made by the Spaniard. She'll need to do so if she is going to get her first win against the unseeded player.
Yeah, she knows it. I would say that Sato is favourite in this match, even though she's not seeded. So there's a lot of pressure for the Spanish girl to try and make her shots. She's got to calm down, bring her margins in.
Bedded themselves into that last point, both players.
You think that when it gets to the final, they've had three, 4 days of hard competition. They might be showing signs of fatigue, but there's none of that. Both these girls are so fit and strong. They're moving around the courts easily. Let's just see if they can keep this up.
Well, indeed she may be, but she's got so much confidence behind her this week in Glasgow Sato, making a debut, in fact, and what a debut it's been all the way through to the final. Already defeated three seeds en route to today's encounter. Number four seed, Janessa of Germany in the second round. Anathea Madsen, the number eight seed from Denmark, and of course yesterday, Kirsty Gilmour of Scotland, the number one seed.
It's a great feeling going into a tournament. You're unseeded and then just knocking them off on the way to the final. Great confidence boost.
6-5.
From the Spaniard, but not by much.
No, but I have to say the line judges have been brilliant this tournament. Really, really good. They've made the decisions very precisely and at the right time. So fantastic call from the line judge.
Serve is over. 6-7.
So much at stake out there. No surprises whatsoever that it is a very tight start to this first final of the day. Not these two players out there today, girl, but a lot of players this week have been playing in singles as well as doubles matches so far this week. She's only been on court longest time, 39 minutes, Corrales. She's the fresher of the two players.
She is, and that's why I'm interested to see how Sato is moving after that grueling battle with Kirsty Gilmour yesterday. At the moment, I don't see any signs that she's suffering at all, but you know, we're still early days, and you know, these girls are so fit now. They have to be as fit as best they can be, really. You cannot be unfit in ladies' singles.
I can see the disappointment there for Sato. Just lacking in the execution. Didn't quite get that in the meat of the strings from the racquet. Still the 1 point, the difference here.
Serve is over. 9-0.
Going for the forehand, deep forehand corner of Sato. Usually when you're playing a left-hander, you would not hit into the forehand corner. That's usually a left-handed strong point and you get lured into hitting there. But Sato's made a couple of mistakes in that forehand corner. So Corrales has obviously done her homework. She's been looking at Sato, seeing where her weaknesses are.
11-9.
Another unforced error there from the racquet of Sato. And it is Corrales, the number two seed, who has a slender advantage at the first interval, albeit by 2 points. Now, Sato on court for 1 hour and 8 minutes yesterday. A grueling match against Kirsty Gilmour. Slowly but surely, she gained confidence, she gained impetus after dropping that first game. Didn't look back after that, really.
She didn't, and it was that resilience that we've seen in Sato before when she was competing pre-ankle injury. She is a tough cookie on that court, and we saw that again yesterday. She used all that experience. And Kirsty Gilmour, whether she was completely 100% well, she was blowing her nose a lot, she looked like she had a cold, whether she was fully fit in the court, didn't really matter. She just got stuck in, and she used that physicality, she used the endurance, and she wore Kirsty down. So, yeah, that was knowing that she's got that in the bag, she can do that to her opponents, again, is a big boost to her.
Serves over. 10-11.
An interesting start by both players, Gail. Both look relaxed at times. Both just look to tighten up.
Yeah, the finals do that to you.
Well, that's too good.
Yeah, really great shot. This, again, you're testing each other out. You're seeing who's the most nervous. You're trying to get used to the conditions. All the conditions change every day. So you want to get your shots in, but you've got to keep your margins in as well, as well as going for a few winners.
And serves over. 12-11.
Well, interesting, we've only had one point that was a winner, and that was a smash, cross-court smash from Sato. Every point these girls have won has been a mistake. If we had to look at the winner and unforced error count, there'd be a big gap.
Still nothing in it at all in this first game. Players do look to their left. They can see the winner's podium there. One of them are going to be standing on top of it. And with that in mind, no surprises to see a few loose shots, a few unforced errors just creep in at times. Gets it. Brilliant rally.
What a rally. That was world-class badminton. It was
50-12.
Ladies singles, they have to cover every inch of the court. They worked each other in every single corner. Corrales just got her feet tangled. She was going back for the round-the-head shot. She was hoping that shuttle would land out, but it dropped in. That's good power from Corrales. She's such a slight girl, yet she jumps up with that smash and can create some power.
Serve's over.
In badminton, when you go for the smash, it's not about the biggest muscles, it's about the timing, getting your body up to the shuttle, using every inch of your body to put into that smash. You don't have to have the biggest guns.
Good to see a Japanese player make the final here, of course, in Glasgow.
14,
started off
16.
On Wednesday, 236 players, 31 nations spread over four continents across the globe. Just two Japanese entries on Wednesday. Of course, the player we're watching now, Sayaka SATO, as well as Kayare Imabepu.
18-14.
Corrales likes that cross-court shot, the cross-court drop shot, around the head. She puts reverse slice on the shuttle, so moving her racket from outside her body to inside, rotates the wrist across. And there's a straight reverse slice. Yeah, she's just put the cross-court reverse slice in the net, the point before, 15, but she shows us how to 18. Do the straight shot. I can't do that shot, never could. Really, really hard to do.
Well, that's a real feather in the cap for the Spaniard, 21 years of age. One of the players on the circuit last year, in fact, that with four wins in five tournaments in just 10 weeks, 18. After a very tense, nervy start, number two seed just beginning to gain confidence. She's really going for her shots now, Gail.
She's pulled that wide. That was a great rally from both girls.
It
was great to see Corrales put some deception on her shot. She's building up her confidence. But she has to. You have to be brave in a final. You can't go in there and expect someone to give you the title. You have to go out there and win it.
Well, Corrales really has taken first game by the scruff of the net. Okay, it's just a point, the difference. The level of badminton really has risen.
Short layer from Sato. Did not get the length that she needed. It wasn't to the back
18.
Of the court. Corrales was able to intercept it very early on. She jumps up, uses that power to cross that shuttle into the space.
Service over. 19-18.
Well, here they are meeting for the second time, these two players, in a final. First meeting was just in round two. Complete demolition job of that day for Sato. 21-8, 21-12. She had everything go all her way. Much tighter affair now. Still the 1 point, the difference between the two. Seen two fantastic movers on the court today, two fantastic strikers off the shuttlecock. Go to work.
20,
yeah, this 18. Is a great showcase for ladies singles. And Sato, she was so patient. she had to work hard in that rally. She had to move around the court, but she didn't try it. She didn't panic. She got into a bit of trouble, got out of it, set herself up really well, put that shuttle into Corrales' backhand, stepped up and really attacked her reply.
Here she is with one chance here to secure the first game. Well, she does that. One chance is all she needs for Sayaka Sato to get the first game on the board here in Glasgow.
First game won by Sayaka Sato.
On the surface, things, girls. She really did step up when she needed to. Perhaps when the Spaniard was just looking like she was going to run away with it, she chiselled out a four-point advantage at one stage.
Yeah, she did. It was a nervy start. Like I said, I don't think there were many winners at all. Maybe one or two from each girls, but the rest of the time, the points came from the opponent's mistake. It is tense, it is nervous, it is a final, but you've got to be brave. You can't rely on the opponent to make mistakes all the time. Corrales has built her confidence back up. She did lose the lead that she had. She's got her confidence up, and she is attacking the shuttle really, really well. But I'm just worried that extra strength from Sato will be too much. Sato is beginning to push Corrales deep into the corners. She's stepping up. She's realizing that it's fine when you hit Corrales' forehand and she can anticipate, when she can get that power behind it. But when she can't, she does look a lot weaker than Sato. So, Sato will take confidence. Both girls haven't got a coach. They're here on their own. So they will have to just make sure they sort things out in their heads in their own way. Unless we go down, Errol, and you choose one and I'll choose the other, we could go down and coach them.
Well, we had a go prior to the players making their way to the court. I can honestly tell you, it wasn't the best viewing from my side of the net. Absolutely. Well, you asked for her to be brave. Now, you were such a brave player in your day, girl. Fortune favours the brave, as we know. And Sato, in her career, perhaps could do with a touch of fortune. Who can forget her, of course, in the London Olympics 2012. Buckets of tears on the court with that injury. Happened to withdraw from a match against the number seven seed of Denmark, of course. 15-11 in that first game. Corrales to serve first here. Sato, sorry, second game here in the final.
One, love.
Here, Corrales has got to keep her energy levels up. She's got to keep moving her feet. She's got to increase her margins of her shots. Too many unforced errors.
Right on cue, really. Will that go down as a forced error or an unforced error?
Oh, that's a tough one. But again, you see Sato creeping up that court. She's pushing Corrales deep into that corner. She's using that strength that she's got to her advantage.
Oh, really is shaping up very nicely indeed now for Sato.
Three, love.
This would be her first prestigious title in her career, Gail, if she were to win. Just talk us through what's going through her mind now if she does creep closer towards getting to the tape here in this match.
Yeah, she will be thinking about that podium. She'll want to be on the top, not in second place, that's for sure.
She gets it again, going cross court this time. That is fantastically placed.
Yeah, there's more winners now from Sato. It's good to see, but you can see the podium from the court. It is there, right in your peripheral vision. You can see the number one spot. You can see the number two spot. It's really annoying they do that to you when you're playing a final. You want to concentrate on the game, but somehow you can see that podium and you just see yourself standing on there.
Badly needed point on the board there from Corrales. Already she's gone one better here this year than she did last year, losing out in the semi-final stage of the tournament to Kirsty Gilmour. Of course, her good friend Marin went ahead to grab the title.
Four, Service over.
Well, Spanish badminton, when I was playing back in the day, Spanish badminton was not in a good place. I think there was one man, maybe from Spain, who used to play in the badminton circuit. And now we've got two very world-class lady singles players, and one of them, Carolina Marin, last year's Scottish Open winner, went and won the World Championships. When you've got someone like that in your camp, not only is she a role model and inspiration, but they're best friends as well. They're sparring partners. They just feed off each other. So for Corrales, it's a great thing that she can have someone like Carolina Marin to turn to and get advice from and just get better with.
Service over.
She's a game down. She's now 4 points adrift in game number two, of course, in the shadow of her good friend Marin, the 2011 European Junior Championship silver for Corrales. Two titles already so far this season. Bulgarian international, as well as the French international, is the number one seed. And of course, a couple of titles last year as well, the Bulgarian international and the Romanian as well.
Looking up to the sky, it's a lazy shot from Sato. She tried to use disguise with her forehand, but if you're going to do that, you need to take the shuttle a little bit earlier. She was too complacent, and in doing so, just pushed that shuttle wide.
She's getting a lot of joy going cross court now.
Yeah, she is. It's just opening up the space, making Corrales work hard, not using as much disguise as possible. Oh, it's gone wide. She read that shot, she read the cross court. Sato's used that cross court from her backhand into the deep forehand corner of Corrales a few times, but Corrales read it this time, but she pushed her shot wide.
She's opened up now, Sato.
Yeah, good smash at the body there. Not only do you have to cover every inch of that court, but sometimes the hardest shot to get back is the ones right at you.
Just seem to be turning to gold right now. After a tense start, well, really has settled into a nice smooth rhythm from Sato's side of the net. All to do right now for Beatriz Corrales, the number two seed. 11-3, the difference for the Japanese player. And well, how good is she looking out there right now?
She's looking really, really good. And Corrales, she saw that shuttle go over the net and instantly she knew her feet couldn't get there and just went, slammed the shuttle back over the net and went off for a break. She needs that break to stop the momentum of Sato. It's 11-3. She's in a very difficult position. She needs to compose herself. She needs to tell herself all the little things that she had in her game plan, all her homework that she's done on Sato. She needs to remind herself of those and just to motivate herself a little bit. Maybe it's just trigger words. I used to have trigger words. Move your feet, keep your racket up, go for space. All these little things that you can just use that sports psychology just to help you get back into this match.
Serve's over. 4-11.
She has been the runner-up on many occasions in recent times. Sato. Runner-up in her last two tournaments, in fact. Victor Korea Grand Prix at the number 7 seed to fellow Japanese, Nozomi Okuhara, 17-21, 13-21, and also the Yonex USA International Challenge as the number 2 seed, again to a Japanese player. Fellow player here this week, Koyore Imabeppu, as the top seed, 19-21, 20-22.
That was a great rally. Both girls were twisting and turning each other. They had to deal with incredible cross-court shots, the ones that they weren't expected. And when they got to the shot, they managed to put another cross-court in. Really high skill level.
Well,
at this stage of the match, a game 12-4 down as she was. Can't give away a cheap point as she did there, Corrales.
Service over.
Is that forehand corner again?
I'm
not sure why. It's when she goes for a drop shot, I think. She's just mistiming it. Whether maybe it could be done to the ankle. Maybe that's in her, the movement for the ankle, I'm not sure, but she's really hesitating and it's not looking smooth at all.
Service over.
She finds the base of the net again, Corrales.
14-5.
If the Renaissance is to be on a late charge, a late surge perhaps, it really does need to start right here, right now. She does get it right in the forehand side of the court. A huge slice of lady luck as well.
We play for those shots. They are such a great shot when it goes over, obviously. And you see that shot trickle over, it's incredible. Such a great feeling. But I was just thinking about all the Japanese squad, the ladies' single squad is really strong at the moment. If Sato does win this match, it's great she's Scottish Open champion, but she's still probably ranked only about 4 or 5 in the Japanese team. So she's still got lots of work to do if she's going to make it to be the best in Japan.
Well, it's a change of shuttlecock. And certainly will need to be a change of fortunes right now for Beatriz Corrales. No stage in this final has she been settled, apart from when she did open up that 4-point lead. It's been a downward spiral since then.
Yeah, she's definitely better in that forehand corner when she hits it hard. It's the soft shots that she's really hesitant about. But the great thing again with the left-handed, you can bring that racket round the shuttle. And it's so awkward to see because you just don't know where it's going to go. And she did that perfectly, just hit straight down the line. Great disguise on that shot.
Service over, 6-17.
What's the shake of the head there from Sato? If you are going to make a mistake, do it. You have such a healthy lead.
Served short.
Service over, 18.
Well, she's just had the confidence almost sucked out of her body, out of her mindset here by Sato. Well, she thought about letting it go. She took it at the last minute.
Six.
And in the end, she paid the price.
I think Sato was surprised that this shot went over the net, and as she attacked it, she was very lucky to keep that shuttle in.
Service over,
And it's just one-way traffic here in Glasgow in the women's singles final.
19.
Sato is demonstrating to us all what a fantastic talent and an excellent badminton player she really is right now. Just looking devoid of confidence right now is Corrales.
Service over. 20.
It's another unforced error from the racket of the number two seed, and after a very tight opening to game number one, it is championship point here to Sayaka Sato of Japan. What an emphatic way to wrap up the title here at the 2014 Scottish Open Grand Prix. The 23-year-old from Sendai, Japan, is the winner here of the women's singles final. Again, it is another two games victory against the number two seed from Spain, 21-18, 21-9. A fantastic masterclass of badminton of the highest order here in Glasgow by Sato. Fantastic effort and a job very well done indeed.
Sayaka, incredible, incredible final. It's been a tough week, but you must be very happy for being Scottish Open champion.
とても素晴らしい試合でした。もう素晴らしく、とても感動しています。今回、スコットランドの国際大会優勝ということなんですが、今、喜びでいっぱいなんでしょうか。そうですね、やっぱりすごい嬉しいんですけど、3年前にロンドンオリンピックで怪我して、
I'm so really glad to be a winner today, especially I injured in a London Olympic 2012, so I'm so glad to be a champion in Scotland, come back to the UK again.
We remember you 2 years ago, in tears, on the courts, with the ankle injury. Everything is good now? Ankle injury, everything is good now.
すべて今順調にやっておりますでしょうか。そうですね、来年からオリンピックレースがまた始まるので、それに向けてちゃんと調整できていると思います。
From next year, in Japan, there will be a competition for be selected as an Olympic player, so I would like to be ready for it.
Fantastic. Sayaka Sato, 2014 Scottish Open, Scottish Open champion. Congratulations. Beatriz, commiserations. You are up against a tough opponent.
Yes, I think I have not a lot to say because today she was ready and she deserved the win. So, yes, congrats to her.
You're very young. You have a great training partner with Carolina Marin, world champion. You must be feeling good about training and getting better and up those world rankings.
Yeah, of course. She did amazing in the world championship. And at the National Center, it's always good to have this kind of teammate to get better. And yes, today I didn't have my best performance, but of course I will try and I keep going.
Next year?
Yeah, sure, I will try.
Fantastic, great final. Let's hear it for Beatriz.
Thank you. Asking the questions in just a moment. The presentation.
Well, what an honour here for the Japanese player Sayaka Sato, joining the role of honour here in Glasgow, winning the women's singles final here in emphatic style. And of course now following fellow Japanese players here, Takahashi in 2012, Yonkura in 2007, as well as Shimada in 2002. What a way to start off proceedings here in Glasgow. It really was excellent demonstration of badminton, and plenty more of that, please, throughout the remainder of the day.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time for the presentations for the women's singles final. Please welcome the players into the arena.
Welcome back to the court here at the Scottish Open Grand Prix 2014 here in the Emirates Arena. And what an entry here for Sato of Japan, led to the winner's rostrum here by the Invachari District Pipe Band. How good are they? Started out in 2003 by renowned piper Stuart Little, who had the vision that one day they could have a pipe band again after being disbanded in the late 1930s. European champions in 2014. And second also this year in the World Pipe Band Championships here in Glasgow, Scotland.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for our presentation party to present the medals, envelopes and trophy. Paul Jensen, Managing Director of Yonex UK Limited, Keith Russell, Head of Sport at Glasgow Life, and Dan Travers, Vice President of Badminton Scotland.
Ladies and gentlemen, the runner-up in the women's singles final from Spain, Beatriz CORRALES! Sayaka SATO! Receiving a winner's medal from Paul Jackson.
Congratulations to Sayaka SATO of Japan, the winner here of the 2014 Women's Singles Final. And again, the fourth Japanese player in this millennium to have the honour to have that wonderful trophy in her hand. Commiserations again to Beatriz CORRALES, the runner-up at the Swiss International, and unfortunately for her, the runner-up here in Glasgow.
And leading the athletes out of the arena, the Inveraray District High Band.